Hello, my name is Lene Hansson and I am from Denmark. I am head of training of Cell Wellbeing and a nutritionist in the Scandinavian countries for more than 25 years. In those 25 years, I've been writing 39 books about health, and today I'm running an academy where I teach other people to become nutritionists. Most of us have heard about DNA and genetics and how they determine development of living systems, but I'm sure not many people have heard about epigenetics and the impact it has on the body cells. DNA produces proteins and structures. These form cells, which turns into tissues, and these turns into organs to a complete system. This is why your lifestyle choices affects the whole body. Here you see some of the epigenetic influences that you actually are capable to control yourself more or less. We use the root hair bulb because the hair works as an antenna and picks up signals from both the macro and the micro environment. By using a hair bulb, we actually use a cell which contains information about the life inside the body and how life outside the body is affecting the cells. At Cell Wellbeing, we strongly believe in prevention. So the mapping of the client is not used for diagnosing of any illnesses or symptoms. The report overview page is the third page you will see and the first page containing information about the client's cell well-being. If you are short of time, then this page provides the key information with which to work. In my opinion, the first priority is to point out the foods which should be avoided. This is because the foods are consuming more energy than they can produce. Removing them from the diet immediately reduces digestive stresses in the system. Later in the report, you will find a page of food sensitivity. Now, these 10 foods to avoid are not allergens. They are merely here to explain you food sensitivities and the system's inability to use these foods. With the professional wellness report, we also provide a page with the 17 different systems. The indicators will show you where the body is under most pressure. The last thing you will see on page 3 is an overview of the specific indicators. It will show you which categories to work with and also the order you should work with them. To go through the report, the way I think you should do it is as follows. First, you view and explain the system page of circulation. Secondly, you view and explain the individual pages of the report. Then you explain about the 10 additives to avoid and you take a look at the attached link. Then you go through the foods to eat table and remove any sensitive items from the 10 foods to avoid. In the end, you go through the 90-day self-assessment checklist. And the last thing you do is you book the next remapping appointment with your clients after 90 days. Why a maximum of 4 priorities? Well, if the system gets overwhelmed or overloaded with all the new information, it might get into an even bigger imbalance. So this is why it's very wise only to work with 4 things in each category. This way, like nature, we work slowly but surely. The indicators are displayed in 4 different ways: priority, advisory, consider, or blank. The indicators are not a measure of scale or level, but reflects the relevance within the body. In the system chart, there are 17 different possibilities where you can aid extra help for your client. In the 17 systems, only a maximum of 4 will be indicated. It is important that you understand that you have also to look for the underlying factors when you do look at the systems. The underlying factors you could look for in amino acids, vitamins, and things like that. This is a picture you need to understand and read in the whole. So you have to use the whole report to understand why the body is most pressured on these maximum 4 different areas. Page of circulation contains 31 different options of nutrients that are important to a healthy circulation system. The more nutrients that is marked, the higher the support is needed. Vitamins are essential for life and optimized cell function. Some vitamins you need every day and some vitamins you only need once in a while. The more raw your food is, the more vitamins you get from the food. The body does not produce minerals naturally and therefore the body must obtain them from food sources. Some minerals you need every day and some only on a regular basis. Fatty acids are essential for an optimized cell well-being. And don't be afraid of fats. You just have to choose the right sources of fats. Fats are an important part of our body cells and also a part of our hormone system. They are also an important source of energy as well as accompaniments of cellular structures. Antioxidants are important substances that protect the body cells. Some antioxidants can be produced by the body itself, but most must come from food sources. You will find antioxidants in certain vitamins and minerals and also in some amino acids. Protein are formed from amino acids and they are part of our hormonal balance, nervous system, immune system and so on. There are 20 amino acids. 8 are produced naturally by the body and 12 must be supplied by a food source. These are known as the essential amino acids. When you eat proteins, these are in your digestive tract transformed into amino acids. The amino acids are then absorbed into the bloodstream and into your body cells where they are again transformed from amino acids into human protein. This is called the protein synthase. In this modern age, radiation has become a significant challenge, and so has chemicals and toxic metals. We are surrounded by it 24 hours of the day, so therefore you can make some healthy food choices and protect the body cells. Resistant relevancy are parasites, virus, bacteria, mold or spores, fungus or post-virus. This is something most of us have been or are in contact with on a regular basis. Every day we are in a modern world affected from electromagnetic waves. These come from television screens, computer monitors, low frequencies, high frequencies, also magnetic fields, microwave and mobile phone. To prevent yourself from being affected from these inevitable factors, you can actually make some healthy food choices to strengthen your body cells. Food sensitivity page. In the back of the report, you will see that there is a list of 10 foods which are highlighted with a red color. This has nothing to do with food allergies or intolerance, but merely means that these foods are foods you are sensitive towards. It's vital that clients are advised to continue to avoid all known food allergens, even if they are not listed here. Modern food processing methods often require the addition of additives which are listed on the packaging of most processed food. Many of these additives are unnatural and can contribute to food sensitivities. Take a look at the list. We have listed 10 E-numbers that your clients should avoid. The more raw food you eat, the more fruit, vegetables and healthy things you put into your mouth, the better for your gut and for the whole system. And actually juicing is a great way to achieve a lot of nutrients. In my 25 years as nutritionist, I've worked a lot with different people and different needs. But one system I see always works is the food combination. The better your combination on the plates are, the better is your digestive tract. So in order to combine the food, you need to mix the food on your plate in a special way. You have the combination chart. There you can see, do not mix the proteins with the carbohydrates. If you eat proteins, fish, chicken or eggs or meat, combine it with vegetables and salad. And the other way around, if you eat carbohydrates group B, mix it with salads and vegetables. This will give you a much better digestive tract. And then, you know, you are what you eat, but you are also what you absorb. So this will give a good balance in the digestive system.